Hey everyone, in this video, we're going to walk through how to solve for the root of a nonlinear equation using Newton's method in Google Sheets. As we went through in a previous video, Newton's method is an open root finding method for nonlinear functions, meaning that we pick an initial x value and then we iteratively solve for our root from that point. I will leave a link to the theory video on Newton's method in the description below. Alright, so we are told to solve for the rightmost root of the function f of x is equal to x squared minus 2 through 10 iterations of Newton's method. So, Newton's method in Google Sheets is relatively easy to implement. The first thing we can do in Newton's method is simply evaluate the derivative of a function, which I have already done here, and you can see that in the top right corner. Now, let's create four headers here. Let's call our first column iteration, and this will just be an easy way of quickly tracking our iteration that we are currently on. Secondly, let's add x, current. This is going to be our x value guess at this iteration. In our third column, let's evaluate our function using the current value of x. Be sure to select the current x value cell for all inputs of x into your function to ensure this formula works as we increase our iterations here shortly. In the next column, we just need to repeat the previous evaluation step, except now we are using the derivative of our function of interest. So let's just do that now. We can now fill in this row using our initial x guess value. Let's just use 2. So, we put that in our initial iteration 0 current guess. And, as you can see, the rest of the columns update with that input. Now, to find our next value of x, we need to use the following formula, which is derived in our Newton's method theory and procedure video that I talked about previously. The idea here is that we can use this first order Taylor series expansion to find the x value at which our tangent crosses the x-axis. So, as this newly found x term is replacing our previous iteration's x value guess, we can put this in iteration 1's current x value. Now, all we need to do is drag down a few rows and columns, and we can validate that our answer is not diverging. Meaning, we can see our current x values trend towards very similar values, and they are not running away from each other. As we want, we can see here that our answer is converging very quickly and very well. If your answer is diverging, I highly recommend that you plot your function of interest and choose a better starting guess. However, this will not fix everything as certain functions, like a step function, cannot be used in Newton's method, like we discussed in the previous theory video. Thank you for checking out this video, and I hope it helped your understanding of how we can implement Newton's method into Google Sheets. If you enjoyed, please like, subscribe, and consider checking out our YouTube memberships or our Patreon page down below. However, if you have any comments, questions, or concerns about the information I provided in this video, please leave a comment down below and I will do my best to address your concerns.